In this video, we will take a closer look at the Attack tab in the Adrenaline Bot interface. The settings of this tab determine how your bot and its pets will behave in battle. Use skills are a normal attack, at what distance you need to attack, and under what conditions. These settings are also used for the assist. You can learn more about it from the video on the Party Settings tab. The first thing we see is a table that displays a list of attacking skills, actions or items, as well as their settings. In the first column, the name, in the second, the type of targets being attacked, in the third, various conditions, in the fourth, the priority of use, in the fifth, the interval before reuse. Below the table are the settings for the selected element in the table, as well as buttons for adding and removing list elements. If you suddenly want to change the order of the element in the list, just drag it with the mouse. Let's consider the available settings. Type. In this drop-down list, we choose what the bot will use when attacking. A character's skill. An item. A pet skill. An action or changing the equipment. Changing the equipment is needed, for example, so that the destroyer attacks with a two-handed sword as usual, but puts on a two-handed blunt on limits. Or Blade Dancer will use a sword and a shield for better tanking, but put on dual swords before the Redance. Or so that Treasure Hunter will make several shots from the bow first, but when the mob comes closer, put on a dagger and finish off the target in melee combat. As for the items, using this tab, you can customize the manner, soul crystals leveling, or chests opening with keys. Name. After choosing the type, select the required skill, item or action from this drop-down list. For ease of search, you can start entering the desired name. Please note that the bot has its own database, and the names may not be the same with those you see in the game. Target. Here we choose on whom the selected attack can be used, on mobs, NPCs, players. Players should be selected if you have set up fighting off PvP or PK players in the target search tab, or if the mobs on your server are made in the form of players. Please note that for each element in the table, the type of attack targets is selected individually. Thanks to these settings, your bot will behave differently in PvP and during farming. Use only for, or use for all, except. Using this setting, you can specify that the selected attack should work either only on specified targets or on all targets but the specified ones. For ease of setting, you can double-click on the field to open an additional window where all visible mobs around will be displayed. Thus, for example, you can set up spoil only on the needed mobs or use keys only on real chests if you are playing on Interlude. Skill distance. Here we can set up the minimum and maximum distance to the target at which the selected attack will be used. These distances are taken from the bot base by default, but you can change them by unchecking the base checkbox. And the move checkbox determines whether the bot should specifically run to the target for an attack if it is further than the maximum distance. It can be disabled, for example, for AoE melee skills, so that the bot uses them only when the target is already near. Editing the minimum distance is useful, for example, for a Berserker's Rush or Tank's Chain, so that the bot won't use them at close range. If you choose to attack with a pet, you can specify a large maximum distance, so that the pet engages first. Main distance. In addition to individual settings for the distance of each attack, you can also adjust the main distance at which the bot will keep relative to the current target during the battle. This adjustment is general for all attacks and is disabled by default, but only with its help you can customize the kiting for archers or mages, simply setting the minimum distance to 100 to 300. Reuse. If this option is enabled, the bot will use the selected attack while the target is alive, otherwise it will be used only once on each target. The bot will use this attack either at the interval you specified or by cooldown if the delay is set to 0 seconds. Moreover, the cooldown will be determined automatically, and the bot won't try to spam the selected attack. If fail. Use this checkbox to make the bot reuse this skill, only if it fails, or if the debuff didn't land. Active skill. This option is required for toggle skills. The aura will be turned on at the beginning of the attack and turned off after killing the target, which will minimize the consumption of MP and HP. However, there is another method that can be configured in self-buffs, which will be described in the video dedicated to this tab. Mobs around. Here you can set up the number of mobs around our bot or the target chosen by it. The setting is relevant for AoE skills or short-term boosts, such as Party Ultimate Defense or Rhapsody. Well, or Fake Death at worst. You can also use BSOE like this. You need to choose the condition and radius in which the mobs will be counted. All mobs are counted by default, but if you enable the aggressive checkbox, then the mobs that do not attack us will not be counted. Use shots. If you need to save shots, this option allows you to flexibly adjust the conditions when and what shots should be used and when they shouldn't be used at all. For example, it can be adjusted so that shots are used only with skills, or only if we have low HP, or lots of mobs are attacking us. The main thing is not to forget to disable the option, auto use all shots in inventory on the miscellaneous tab. Conditions. Here you can set up to 4 different conditions for use of the selected skill, item or action. The type of condition is selected on the left, on the right the value with which it should be compared. For different types of conditions you need to enter different things here. For example, all possible conditions for HP MP CP are indicated here either percent or absolute values. There are also conditions where you don't need to specify any value at all, but there are those where you need to specify ID of buffs, items or skills. In such conditions, you usually can double-click to bring up a list in which you can select the desired values with checkmarks. When you select the attack position condition, your current coordinates are automatically substituted. This condition works as follows: if our target is within a radius of 250 from a given point, the selected attack will be used. If you set up 2 or more conditions, they must be used simultaneously to attack. If you need an attack to be applied according to first condition or second, just make 2 attacks in the list and specify 1 condition for each. Be careful when you setting the conditions, they must not contradict each other, otherwise the attack will not be used at all. Priority. This scale is responsible for the sequence of using attack actions if they have the same conditions. To change the priority you just need to drag slider up or down, the higher slider the higher the priority. In addition, the order of attacks is influenced by the order in which they appear in the table, i.e. if 2 attacks have the same priority, the one that comes first in the list will be used first. Let's look at simple example. We have a destroyer and we want him to hit with an auto attack and some skill. First of all, let's add a skill. Select a skill type, then select Crush of Doom from the list, and press the Add button. Let's configure this skill to be used on both mobs and players. And let's also indicate that the bot uses this skill only if the target's HP is more than 50%. As you can see, everything is quite simple. Now let's add a normal attack. Select the action type, select attack, and indicate that it can also be used on players. Press add. Although the setup is simple, you can already farm on it. Now you know everything about setting up an attack in the Adrenaline Bot interface. If you want to know about the setting of other tabs, watch the video on our channel. And also subscribe and learn more about the capabilities of the Adrenaline Bot and scripts for it. You can buy a bot on our official website adrenalinebot.com. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our technical support in Discord.